Do you remember those truth commercials that seemed a little depressing, but the idea of the commercial was actually to show you the harmful side effects of tobacco, not just what it can do to your body, but what it can do to your social life and your life in general. Well, now every year there's a truth tour. It's something where young adults called truth writers can connect with hundreds of thousands of teens and young people across the country, allowing teens to experience the truth campaign firsthand. With a big orange truth truck, a DJ, music, games, and prizes in the Truth Zone on tour, young people get to participate in an experiment that is both entertaining and educational. With nearly 86% of smokers starting to smoke before age 18, it's important to reach young people before they make the decision to smoke. So as part of a larger tour, Truth is visiting more than 50 cities and 25 states this summer, making more than 100 stops along the way. Join me on the program with more about this year's Truth Tour is the Associate Vice President of Communications for Legacy, Patricia McLaughlin, and returning Truth Tour writer and California native, Chelsea Warneke. Welcome to the show, Chelsea and Patricia. It's such a pleasure to have you both on.
Thank you. Great to talk to you, Brynn.
And like I said, it's great to talk with you as well. So talk to us a little bit about what the Truth Tour is for those people who maybe aren't familiar with it.
So what Truth is we are the nation's largest youth smoking prevention campaign. And what we're doing this summer is we're traveling with a few different music festivals as well as sport festivals, and some Six Flags, talking to teens about the effects of tobacco, but making it entertaining. We're not preaching. We play games. We have dance parties. We have karaoke. But all at the same time, we're telling these teens about the negative effects of tobacco so they can make an informed decision on whether they'd like to be smokers or not.
So it sounds like rather than just educating and handing out pamphlets, it's finding that fun way to teach your peers about some of the pressures when it comes to smoking.
Absolutely, because once you start preaching, then they stop listening. So what we do is we have, peer-to-peer interactions. All of us truth writers, we're in our 20s, so we're speaking to these teens, so we can relate to them. As soon as you start preaching, they stop listening. So what we do is we play games with them throughout the day, and every time someone interacts with us, they get a free piece of gear, like a t-shirt or sunglasses or a hat, and all of our gear has different tobacco facts written on it. So not only are they having a great time and they're creating memories with us and we're influencing them in a positive way, but they're also leaving us with a piece of gear that's informing them about the negative effects of tobacco.
Well, Chelsea, as a returning Truth Tour writer, how did you get involved with the group in the beginning?
So I've been going to the Vans Warped Tour since I was 14 years old, and I'm 23 now. My mother used to smoke, and it was, even at a really young age, I knew it was something that I didn't want her doing, so it's always been something that's very close and personal to me. So since I've been going to the Vans Warped Tour for almost 10 years now, I used to go up to the Truth Truck every year that I went to Warped Tour. And finally, when I was in my 20s, I asked them, I was like, how do I get involved? Like, I love your cause. I love what you're doing. I applied, and now here I am. This is my second year as a Truth Tour writer.
Now, Patricia, Chelsea hit on something that brings about a question. Do you find that most teens who do feel more tempted by smoking have a family member who they see smoking on a regular basis?
Well, research has proven that if family members smoke, like parents around that, then teens are more likely to take up the habit. It's all what their surroundings are. We know 1,000 youth per day become daily smokers, so that's still a huge amount. And really what we're trying to do is combat that. We want to get into their minds. We want to talk to them. We want to educate them before they make the fateful choice to smoke.
Okay. What are some of the educational factors that you're bringing about to these teens to really help them see that it's something that it's not great for their body and it really does affect their health?
Well, we do it in a lot of ways. Truth's been around since 2000, and so we started out as really a traditional advertising campaign. We were very known for some really edgy, hard-hitting commercials in the early 2000s that you could see on TV. And we've evolved the campaign as teens evolve. I mean, we know the teens are all over social and digital media. That's how they communicate with their friends. That's how they get their news. That's how they discuss things with each other. And so we've had a heavy, robust presence at our main website, thetruth.com, and then at affiliated social media sites on things like Pinterest and Twitter. But touring has been a key part of what we do every summer. We thoroughly believe that these one-on-one interactions, when you have people like Chelsea and our other tour riders talking to teens, really makes a difference. first and foremost, we provide a fun experience out there in the zone. We make it attractive, something that they want to participate in. They want to play a game. They want to hear the music. They want to get a free piece of truth gear. And then we put those subtle educational messages underneath.
Now, Chelsea, how have you noticed something like social media really impacting people and that temptation to want to fit in and therefore possibly start smoking?
Well, I definitely feel that everyone is influenced by their peers in social media as well. I mean, as soon as, you know, you post anything online, then your friends are going to see it. So I absolutely believe that your friends influence you, social media influences you, your family. You know, so we're out here, we're trying to get them before they even start, because 86% of adult smokers start smoking by the age of 18. So we would rather just prevent all illnesses associated with tobacco use altogether.
Well, this question is for either of you, but for those people who maybe can't make it to some of the festivals where the Truth Tour is going to be stopping, what are some things that they can do today just to help make sure they're not giving into that pressure and that their friends and their family are doing the same and that they're rising above and being that person who is not giving into smoking?
Well, I mean, there's a couple different ways that you can approach this. You know, if you have a family member who's smoking or a friend, one of the worst things you can do is nag them about it. You know, people generally know it's bad for you. 70% of smokers want to quit, but it's really, really difficult to quit. So always try to support your family and friends in terms of these addictions. But there's other ways people can get involved. They can go to thetruth.com. They can really see photos and social media feeds from the road, so they'll get a sense of what our truth tour riders are doing out there. But you can also look in your local community. A lot of local groups across the country, they have youth activist groups where people can get involved with this issue on the ground. They can talk to their peers in high school and things like that. So there's definitely ways that you can get involved.
Now, you brought up a very interesting point with nagging people about it. I would think that that would be something that would be ineffective, because oftentimes if someone's nagging us about something, it pushes us further away.
No, that's exactly right. I mean, the last thing you want to do is discourage people. You want to support them in any way you can. You know, there's a few proven techniques in terms of quitting tobacco. One of them is trying to get some kind of nicotine replacement product, these things that are safe and effective, like the patch or the gum. A lot of times you can go to smoking cessation classes or get online or telephone counseling where you can talk to somebody and they can help you identify your triggers and identify what how the addiction is bothering your body and what you can do to solve that. But really, you want to be supportive. Most smokers are really desperate to quit or ashamed that they're smoking in the first place. So the last thing you want to be is a discouragement.
Okay, and that definitely is understandable, because no one wants to feel discouraged and no one wants to feel as if they're doing something wrong, even though they know it's something that they should be quitting.
That's right, and it's such a difficult addiction. Nicotine is one of the most addictive substances on earth, and so, you know, really people need to know that they're not alone in this battle, that they can look to other folks, they can look to expertise at local hospitals or local public health centers, that kind of thing, and really try to tackle this addiction.
So where can people go for more information about tackling the addiction and also more information about all of the stops you guys will be making on the Truth Tour?
Oh, well, they can always go to our website, thetruth.com. We have a lot of different outlets on there, as well as the schedule saying where we're going to be next. And they can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram as well.
Awesome. Thanks so much for coming on the program, ladies.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you.